Julian Batley. That's my home. But Mom, Batley and I aren't hanging out. This one know what I know.
Well, keep the sound down. It's not your father's idol.
He needs me. Don't thank me. Deal with my special good morning, Pounce Piglet. No time to chase lounge around. I gotta go, little guy.
Where are you going, Tigger?
I gotta hit the road, little Butterooney. I'm hearing the call of the wild.
Call of the wild?
Oh, yeah. Once a year, I go off on a long explore by myself, just to sharpen my jungle instincts, and I grow at the moon. Run with the pack! You know, that kind of stuff.
Tigger, cool, bounce, and pounce, and other tiggery things. I'll miss you.
Really? You will?
Me too.
Holy Cleveland! I never thunk of that. You're right. I couldn't possibly leave the 100-acre woods tiggerless.
What do we do?
Well, I'll have to find a replacement. But who? After all,
Piglet.
I'm the only one. What about you, Piglet? Could you be the new me? Just for a while.
Me? Oh, yes. I'd love to be you. After all, tiggers are such large, bouncy animals, and piglets are so small and unbouncy.
Splendiferous! Then we'll start the RTTP, Death Rigorous Tiggerous Training Program, right away!
Stand at you, piggy! Stand at you, piggy! Stand at you, piggy!
This is the first phase of your training, better known as bouncing. Show me what you got, piglet!
Back at Batley and Julie.
Ta te ti to tu.
Ta te ti to tu. Me do a lot. But I can't stand. Oh, I'm back! Tank end here! I'm back! What the heck? What the heck are you doing? We got some pets, Grandpa. A cosmonaut dress. Isn't it lovely? A coat. Pink. How do you like them, dear?
How did you get on the Russian Halloween this year?
Batley and I.
Julie. How gonna you get that Russian Halloween this year? How about we get that Russian Halloween this year? Russian Halloween this year. How gonna be getting the Russian Halloween this year? Fine.
Come up behind me. Shout and pounce on me. Go ahead.
Bye.
just made my whole day brighter.
Oh, you're just trying to be nice. I don't make a very good Tigger, do I?
Oh, now. What kind of talk is that, my little pig, Tigger Latini? I guess I haven't told you the most important thing about being a Tigger.
Oh, what's that?
Your mental altitude.
Don't you mean mental attitude?
No, I mean altitude. If you wanna talk the talk, and walk the walk. If you wanna bounce the bounce, and pounce the pounce, let your thinker fly way up high. You'll soon see why. There's no doubt, it's all about mental altitude. You gotta have a Tiggerific mental altitude.
But I don't even look like a Tigger.
If you haven't got stripes, no need to run and hide. You can still be a guy who wears his stripes inside. And just knowing the stripes hard air will make you dare to try and find a Tiggerish kind of mental altitude. A bouncer-ish's Tiggeristic mental altitude.
Well, I don't know.
It's confidentiality that makes a piglet roar. What else could whaleify a mere sardine? So rev your thinking engine up and watch your spirit soar. You'll see the world will be your trampoline. And then you'll talker it a talk.
And walkify the walk.
Come on and bouncelate the bounce.
And pouncetize the pounce.
And I think that you'll find you'll be a lot like me if day and night you keep the right mental altitude. A bumptious, scrumptious, tiggerific mental altitude. A joyful, umptious, tiggertastic, bouncish, pouncy, quite elastic, jumpalicious, bumperastic mental altitude. You have earned your stripes, young Tiglet. Rise, Sir Tigger Replacement. Go forth and pounce. Okay, I gotta go. To call it a wild waste for no Tigger, but you are gonna do great, TTFN.
TTFN? Well, here goes nothing. Hello? Who's there?
It's me, Tiglet. T-I-double-glet.
I hope I didn't harm you, Rabbit. If so, I apologize most sincerely.
You are too wiggler.
What are you doing, Piglet? Oh, well, you see, I'm the new replacement for Tigger.
But why?
T-H-T-L-F-A-F-D.
What does that mean?
Tigger had to leave for a few days.
Piglet, why don't you just go back to being yourself?
Don't be ridiculous, oh furry bunny type person with ears. Ooh.
Oh, please, Piglet, just call me by my real name, all right?
Oh, all right. Sorry, Rabbit.
Meanwhile, elsewhere in the woods, Tigger realized he had forgotten his...
Stop!
Fresh breath is very important when you're prowling the jungle.
So he rushed back home to get it.
Oh, look, Piglet's hanging out with old long ears. Make me proud, little Tiglet.
So you think I'm a bad replacement, Rabbit?
Oh, no, Piglet, no, you're doing a fine job. In fact, if you'd like to know the truth, I wish the real Tigger were a bit more smart and polite like you.
Do my ears deceive me? Floppy Ears thinks I'm a terrible Tigger. Oh, who would have thunk a Piglet would be a better Tigger than a Tigger? Oh, it's all over for me. I probably wouldn't even make a good Piglet.
Oh, hello, Tigger. What are you doing back so soon?
Oh, I'm just stopping by to say hello so I could say goodbye, I'm afraid. I'll be leaving the 100-acre wood for good, little buddy.
Leave? Oh, but why?
Well, because that's what washed-up Tiggers do best. You're the new stripes in town, kid. Enjoy the ride. Oh.
Oh, favorite rate, too.
Okay, up they go. That 1, 2, 3. Oh.
Hallelujah, Santa Trophy. Piglet, you are mental. I'll do, dude. Oh, how thrilling! Curtain call! Oh!